How many times have you searched Google for the best types of supplements for anxiety, the best brands, only to become more confused? 88 Herbs, the main sponsor for this episode of the Anxiety Guy podcast, makes finding the right supplement for your anxiety easy for you. 88 Herbs specializes in finding the highest quality and most potent natural ingredients in the world, and using only these in each of their products. They have thousands of loyal customers all over the world, and Dennis himself, as well as most of the Anxiety Guy team, have used these very supplements on their road to recovery from anxiety. A powerful anxiety supplement is an essential sidekick to a great CBT program, and this winning combination has led to thousands of success stories around the world. Go to www.88herbs.com and use the promo code ANXIETY88 to get 15% off your entire order today.
Welcome to episode number 65 of the Anxiety Guy podcast. I'm Dennis Simsek, and I will be running you through this podcast episode today. Powerful, inspirational. Let's get driven. Let's start tackling some problems, guys. Today we're talking about the top five questions that you must ask yourself today if you want your mental health to improve, if you want your physical health to improve, if you want to feel inspired, motivated, driven, whatever it is. So today we stop avoiding, today we start confronting, we turn from victim to warrior. And you know, a lot of times it's possible that there's a little imbalance in our minds, in our bodies, simply because we haven't really dealt with things from the past. Between the ages of 0 and 10, that was basically when the first instances of generalized anxiety began for most people. Whenever I work with people online through the program, we always go, you know what? When did it begin? When was it? When was that first traumatic event? And almost every single time, people start telling me it's between the ages of 0 and 10. Now, we must ask ourselves, this isn't part of the questions, but this is a question that we must begin with. What's been the inner conflict inside of us? What's been the inner conflict inside of us? What's been getting in the way? What has prevented you from crushing it, from destroying this problem, from living life at a place where you can truly feel fulfilled, joyful, happy, whatever it is? And what low standard have you tolerated for so long? What low standard have you tolerated? The world tells you you can't do something. The world says you're going to have to live with anxiety forever, that it's a chemical imbalance, and that, you know what, it's just part of your genes. I've heard the stories again and again. I've defied my fears. I've overcome these things. I've desensitized myself, and so can you. Today, we're going to ask ourselves these questions, and we're going to get to know ourselves a little bit better. We're going to find out what the real challenge is, the one challenge that's been holding us back for so long, and we're going to find this path as far as peeling the onion to begin getting our mental health to a level where we're proud of it, where we're proud of ourselves, where we can help other people, where we can get our careers to the next level, where we can get our relationships to the next level. Everything, beginning the snowball effect, beginning the momentum in the direction of our true voice, and getting rid of our critical voice once and for all. Question number one you must ask yourself is this: what is it that's not where you want it to be? What is it that's not where you want it to be? Is it your body? Is it your diet? Is it that your generalized anxiety is basically going from one aspect to another aspect to another aspect in your life, and there's a chain of events there? What is it that's not where you want it to be? Ask yourself this question. How many times have you asked yourself this question in the last couple weeks? How many times have you actually had a conversation with yourself as far as going, you know what? What is it that I'm doing that's contributing to more anxiety, worsening my mental health, worsening my drive for life, my inspiration, my creativity is taking a hit? Why are my relationships failing? Why can't I make the money I want to? When was the last time you started to ask yourself these direct questions? and once and for all get to the bottom of everything, writing down those core beliefs. Number two, what are you not doing that you should be doing to reach your goal? What are the excuses you keep telling yourself? A lot of times with me, with health anxiety, as soon as I saw some success, my sensations lessened, my attention to those thoughts lessened, my attention to anything that might be catastrophic lessened, I started to ask myself, what was I doing that was in fact pulling me from being really focused in on my inner world in a very narrow view, and then putting my attention into the external world in a more broader view? What was it? So I ask you today, what are you not doing that you should be doing to reach your goal? What are those mumbling suggestions in your mind? What is your critical voice telling you? What are you procrastinating? What do you know you should be doing but you're not doing? Ask yourself. Number three, what are you doing all this for? What's life about? What is your metaphor for life? What is your drive that's going to get you to understand that setbacks are inevitable? Setbacks are a part of recovery from anxiety. Setbacks are inevitable in anything that we want to partake in as far as getting our careers to the next level, whatever it may be. There's always going to be challenges. There's always going to be setbacks. So what are you doing all this for? What is your drive? What will create the change within you starting today? Best thing I ever did was to get a couple of photos, put them in my wallet, and always remind myself for why I was challenging my thought patterns, why I had to change my belief systems, why I had to replace some of those behaviors, why I had to tackle some of those core beliefs that have been living with me since the ages of 0 and 10 about people, about the world, and about myself. What are those? What has to happen for you to hit the target that you want? Number four, what has to happen for you to hit the target that you want? When will you know? When will you know that you have achieved what you want to achieve? And don't go thinking these bland, general answers like, I just want to lessen my anxiety levels. Your mind has no idea what the hell you're talking about. What you must do is direct your mind in a very specific manner. And that means that I want to be a social butterfly. I want to mingle with people at a level that I haven't mingled in a very long time. And I want to keep my conversations with people going for a minimum of 2 to 3 minutes. That is specific. Now your mind is directed in a way where it will show you the answers. Maybe not today, maybe not this week, but it will start showing you the answers. Okay, so what has to happen for you to hit the target you want? When will you know? Number five, what will you begin doing today that you know you should be doing consistently in order to achieve your goals? We must first and foremost come up with the action steps that we must take in order for us to get to a place of desensitization from our fears, desensitization from other people and conversations with them, my sensations, my fears of the morning, the afternoon, the evening, my fears of being alone with my breath in meditation or yoga, or my fears around exercise. What must I do today? Because I'll tell you one thing, if you're a regular on the Anxiety Guy podcast, then you, my friends, are very educated. You are very knowledgeable. You know cognitive behavioral therapy quite well. You know neuro-linguistic programming quite well, which are the two things that I am in fact a practitioner around. So you are educated. You know what you must do, but there's something holding you back until today. Today is the day where you start to take action. You don't think about doing something. You don't brainstorm how to do it. You basically begin doing it. And after you do it, you will start to adjust as you go along in the road. okay? You know, I've got to clean up my diet. That may be that I've got to learn relaxation exercises. That may be that I've got to change some of these behaviors, these routines, these rituals that I do on a daily basis. Or it might even be I've got to just audit my friends list. There are things out there that are increasing your anxiety levels. You're going to the mall every day. You're watching House of Cards. You're listening to music that sucks. You're getting caught up in worldwide news, which you think you should be for some reason because the world says, you know what, you should be watching more news. You've got to stay ahead as far as the current events go. I never watch the news and I love it. I love it. I'm so done with the drama, the fear, the negativity, the pessimism. You know, look at the areas in your life where you believe your anxiety is rising due to those things and begin taking action around those things starting today, guys. Action is the greatest tool against anxiety. It's not about sitting around. It's not about hoping, okay? And if you have any questions, I am an email away at anxietyexit.com. I'll see you guys very, very soon. I love you. You are more than anxiety. Bye, guys.
Thanks for being an important part of the Anxiety Guy podcast community. If you enjoyed this podcast, please leave a positive rate and review. If you're searching for further support on your road to recovery from anxiety, head over to anxietyexit.com and take part in the powerful End the Anxiety program based around the CBT model. If you're searching for a more one-on-one approach, you can sign up now for personal coaching sessions with Dennis via Skype. Remember, you are more than anxiety. See you in the next episode.